A very good evening, one and all, and welcome to the National Ice Centre here in Nottingham. It's the final regular season game for the Nottingham Lions. They host the Billingham Stars, and with only 10 minutes to go in the game between Solihull and the Sheffield Scimitars, it seems likely that the Lions will also be playing next week against the Solway Sharks in the playoffs. And I've been told that do now have ice time for that game, because unfortunately we've had to move the Vipers off their ice time next weekend, as the Lions come out onto the ice, led out by starting netminder number 34 Matty Bloor, which gives me an ideal time to go through the rest of the Lions lineup. Number 18 Isaac Ballinger is the backup netminder this evening. 4 Jacob Race, 7 Xander Cleaves, 10 Michael Berehowski, 11 Jack Croston, 12 Myles Keogh, 14 Toby Fisher, 18 Ryan Keogh, 6 Ben Marples, 21 is Parson Mervans. This is a 16-year-old who turned 16 on Tuesday and is making his debut for the Nottingham Lions this evening. Number 23 Zach Yokoyama, 25 Owen Davis, 27 Josh Dowds, 28 Kieran Gibbs, 29 Dan Martin, as the Billingham Stars in their all black with red trim come out onto the ice. 75 Finlay Wall, 87 Tyler Summerton, 91 Ethan Wilcox, 94 Robert Oxley, 95 Billy Crofts, and 96 Tristan Grimshaw. The Billingham Stars have Tom Brown, who seems to be the netminder who's going to be making the start this evening. 2 Jacob Hammond backing him up. 5 James Moss, 8 Joseph Walls, 6 Sam Dowd, 12 Tommy Spraggan, 14 James Helens, 15 Chris Sykes, 19 Sean Galloway, 21 Andrew Munro, 23 Jack Emerson, 26 is Roland Grittens, 32 Michael Elder, 35 Tom Wakefield, 38 Stuart Jackson, 40 is Ethan McLaughlin, 77 Lewis Hall, 81 Joe Dowdle, and 88 Lewis Dowdle. We're going to have fun with that throughout the course of
the afternoon.
And 98 Alex Preston. Both teams are on the blue lines. We'll just have a quick pause for the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen,
anthem done then. We're not too far away from getting this one underway, so it's time for me to introduce my co-commentator for this evening, an Elite League commentator with the Manchester Storm, Max Artis. Max, it's been a while since we've both been here together.
I know. It feels strange having someone stood next to me and someone to actually converse with. It's quite nice.
I know. It makes the life a lot easier, doesn't it?
Having two sets of eyes on the game, there's less chance of one person missing something and somebody else picking something up.
Yes, there is. That's very true. So Lions in their white with black and gold trim away to our right hand side, going into their huddle. The Stars on the left in well, it looks black. It's a very, very dark brown, or black into kind of a dark.
It's a fade.
Yeah, it's a fade, isn't it?
Thing that was very, very popular in the 90s, early 2000s in the NHL. Like they loved the gradient. They loved the fade. Bit of a throwback look for the Stars that they've kind of kept with by the looks of things.
Well, as always on these live streams, get involved on the chat. Good evening to Lowlander, Smiler Fangirl, David, Ben as well, who's looking forward to me sending in the highlights of this game again.
Fair enough.
Helen and Caitlin as well. So we hope you enjoy things. And I'll say it before we get started, no, the clock does not work.
Yes.
The clock doesn't work because we're both busy watching the game.
And trying to keep you as informed as
yeah,
possible.
Yeah, exactly. So Lions are going down the line with their fist bumps. Matty Bloor in net there.
Just one thing on the live chat. If you are not subscribed yet, you have plenty of time to do so during the game. If you're subscribed for more than 5 minutes, you can be involved with the live chat. So hit that subscribe button, get involved. There's plenty of regular names that I've heard you read out already. Join the community that is thriving down there in the live chat that we'll get involved with.
Yeah, Caitlin wants a petition for more gradient jerseys.
And then Anthony
says, let's see what happens in this. I mean, I do like them. What it's telling me is that I need an updated prescription on my glasses to be able to see the colours a bit better. So. Now we're just about ready to get this one started then. We are underway. Lions win the first face-off, go straight to Marples, who backhands it straight down. And that'll be comfortably covered by Brown. 7 seconds gone. I hope the whole game flows a bit better than that first seven.
Just took an odd bounce, and with the fresh ice, he's going to slide in on the goalie. Defenseman didn't really handle that little dump in.
Early face-off then for the Lions in the offensive zone. Yokoyama wins it out to the right. And he takes the deflection out in front, and that's loose. And
sat there for a minute.
Yeah, a couple of sticks get that one away. Stars with their first attack of the game on the left-hand side, cutting in right in front of Bloor, but just loses it, just James Moss, as it goes across the crease. Comes back to the Lions here, Summerton. Summerton loses it, Sykes gains it. His shot goes wide. Stars now trying to work it down low with Gretans, goes back to Moss, out in front, and takes a deflection, and Lions can bank it off the wall, and here's Summerton. Summerton on the left-hand side with Fisher in support. Summerton takes the shot, and it is blocked behind. Moss will collect. Stars with a long opening shift for the top line as they enter the zone again. On the backhand, cutting inside is Sykes, still with it. Backhands it up and over, blowing it, bounces down on the goal line, and referee stops play, and Bloor didn't really know where that was.
Yeah, then puck came up in the air. Bloor smartly just gets his pads down and covers as much of that bottom of the net as possible, with the puck falling right beside the post. Unfortunately, fortunately, kicks it off and causes a whistle.
That bounce in the crease, that
could have gone anywhere. A couple of nervy moments for both goaltenders at
each end. Toby Fisher's already running down back to the dressing room after a minute and 5 seconds, so I hope nothing's too wrong. The fact he was running down doesn't tell me that anything's wrong. I wonder if it's something as trivial as he's forgotten his mouth guard or something.
Or something equipment-wise, helmet or something like that.
He's clearly not injured because he ran down there as a shot comes in and Bloor makes a good glove save. 1:20 gone, and we've had 3 stoppages already. This could be a long one tonight.
And like I said a second ago, a few nervy moments for each goaltender. Flashing pucks through the crease, a couple of opportunities, a crazy bounce already.
I mean, if that's anything to go by for the game, it's probably going to end up 9-8 or something, isn't it? And neither of us will have a voice by the end of it.
And you'll have more time to put in the highlights.
Fun! Here are the Stars at the left corner boards, deflecting in. And the shot that came in from Helens was blocked at source. Here he is again. Stars go D to D. Lovely pass forward, looking for Galloway. He just can't control it the way he would have liked. Myos Keogh rings one round the boards, up to the right-hand side. Up and over the red line goes Kieran Gibbs. We'll keep you abreast of other scores in NIHL 1. See how that affects the playoff race as that goes all the way down for an icing, which I'm sure Anthony in the chat will tell me as well.
I was about to say, we've got some very dedicated people in the chat doing some fantastic voluntary work, keeping us up to date with scores from around the other rinks in the UK.
Face-off won again by the Lions, deflected, and it's a comfortable save. 5 minutes left of the game, but that's become interesting because Scimitars 4-2 down now with 5 minutes to go. They've got another one back. They were down 4-0.
Okay.
And they've got two back to make it 4-2. So that's an interesting one there. The Scimitars 1 point behind the Lions going into this final day of the regular season. So if the Scimitars, they have to win, But if the Scimitars win and Lions lose, then it's the Scimitars that get that eighth spot, as it's been taken away really nicely there by the Lions, up into the offensive zone, shot in, and that's not been covered and loose, and that hit iron.
It's still not dealt with around the back of the goal. Barowski putting good forechecking pressure on. Stars do eventually clear the zone.
Lions doing well. You're ambitious if you want NIHL North on flash scores, Max. I'm going to be honest.
I was looking at Elite League. I was just checking what else has been happening around the UK hockey scene.
Stars go offside. Joe Dowdall quite quick enough to bring that in. So 5 minutes to go in Solihull. Scimitars two goals down. That could make things really interesting if they win that one.
Crazier things in hockey have happened. Crazier things have happened. It's just a bounce, pull the goalie, get back within one, get back within, get tied up, and then anything happens in overtime or a shootout.
Face off won by Stars. They go to Helens. Just checks his stride behind his net. It's been given away to Yokoyama. Yokoyama leaves it back, and the Lions just can't find, Summerton can't find Fisher, who's back out onto the ice. So, as I said, nothing major when he went darting down the tunnel. There's now a scrum in front of the Zamboni doors. Yokoyama fishes it out. Helps it on its way to Fisher. Fisher up the boards again, looking for Summerton. Stars, though, win it back. Here is Helens again. Helens over to the left-hand side. Fast-moving game so far as Yokoyama gets a nice poke check in. Dowdall has to go and collect that one, and Stars just forced to go behind their own net. Lions take the opportunity for a change. That pass is going to go all the way down. No icing called, though. Lions have got to go and get it. Here's Xander Cleaves. Cleaves tries to go around the right-hand boards. That's going to go all the way down. That will be an icing. Yes, it will.
Yeah. Bit of a crazy giveaway from the Stars in the zone, but probably Lions getting a bit too fancy with one drop pass and then a second one immediately afterwards. Interesting to see how the Lions kind of gel together with Yokoyama coming back from his suspension and Summerton playing a more prolific role in the lineup in recent weeks.
Final 2 minutes in that game in Solihull now, so it needs one hell of a finish to stop the Lions getting a playoff game. It would be against the Solway Sharks next weekend. So here come the Stars through the centre ice. Over to the left and away from one as well. Xander Cleaves there completely missing his hit. Here's Galloway. Galloway gives it onto the left-hand side. Now Munro. Shot in. Padded away by Bloor, and it's just kept in on the blue line. Shot in again. Is deflected well high and wide before it gets anywhere near to the Lions netminder. Munro. Munro over to the left. Shot is deflected actually by Walls. Lions just struggling at the moment to get out of their own zone. That chip pass is something for Gibbs to chase. Gibbs in a battle with it against Grittans. It's Grittans who wins it, and on the left hand side, Stars have it now. Cutting inside of one and two. Nice strong play with the body from the Stars. That's Preston with a nice move around a couple of Lions players. Gibbs then gets it out to Dan Martin, back to Gibbs. And as Gibbs tries to play it forward, it comes back to the Stars again. Here's Hall. Hall with a slap shot. That took a deflection that wrong-footed Bloor a little bit as Parson Mervin gets on the ice. Here he is chasing that one down. On the ice is Mervand, as that is cleared by the Stars up to neutral ice, and they've got a fortunate puck bounce as well on the left, and shot is wide of Bloor and just gets held up behind the net. Game starting to open up a little bit now for the Stars as it's helped around the boards by Oxley, but doesn't get out of the zone. Stars can keep it in once more. We've played 6 minutes and 20 seconds of this first period. So then the Lions lose an edge and can't get out of the zone. Now eventually it does. On the red line, the Stars throws it back in, and Bloor will not get everything on it, but he will allow play to continue. Lions just looking for a decent spell of possession here with the puck, because they've not done anything for a few minutes now as the Stars come again with Moss. Moss shoots straight into the logo of Bloor, and with 13:11 to go in the first period, it's still 0-0, Max.
Yeah, Lions look a little bit nervy, kind of rushing the passes, kind of putting a bit too much on them, can't really receive them cleanly. That's what's kind of compounding the pressure inside the zone right now.
Final score in Solihull. The Barons have won by 4-2, so the Lions have qualified for the playoffs in 8th place. As here is Yukiyama. Yukiyama trying to put a move on, manages just about to keep hold of the puck, then gets a bit of an open ice check, and it just disrupts him as the puck then balances on the top of the boards. At the corner board, back out in front, Summerton. That's going dangerously across the net. Lions keep it in the zone. Back to Summerton again, who's wanting to turn and take a shot. And that's saved and not held. And Fisher can't get a shot away. Fisher now on the left-hand side. Back down low towards Yukiyama. Summerton battling hard, and Summerton winning the puck again. Back out to the right point. Opportunity for the shot to come in. Scored! Lions take the lead! What a slap shot from the point! The Billy Crofts and the Lions, with 7:33 gone, have taken the lead against the Stars, 1-0.
Yeah, you don't get many shots from the point going all the way through and past the goaltender, but big credit's got to go to Summerton for the dogged work behind the net in the corner, get that puck back and back to the point. A great assist on that play. And that's the pressure that the Lions wanted just moments ago that we mentioned.
Lions then lead by... Oh, I've got the scoreboard soon as well, haven't I? You can tell it's been a while since I've done this.
Just like riding a bike, don't worry about it. Meanwhile, Stars back in over the blue line. Drive round into the corner, stop, tries to go in front, nothing doing there. Forced away by the Lions, takes a skate out of the zone. Ahead to Summerton, bouncing, bobbling puck. Eventually gets it over the red and dumped into the zone. Stars take over, come up this near side. Step around one. Matty Bloor aggressively out to play that one. Stars hold the zone. Back with the Lions around the back of the goal. As the goal gets announced inside the arena tonight. Following up, and Lions in over the blue line. Just stopped up on the half wall. Now play around the back of the goal. Trying to send it out in front. Nothing doing there. And Stars goaltender puts a glove on top of it. And we'll have a stoppage.
Oh, the Panthers have pulled it back to 4-3 as well.
That's what I was checking a second ago.
it's because I get the alerts. 8:40 oh, yes. Gone in this one. Lions up by a goal. With the offensive face-off on the right-hand side. Comes back as that one just doesn't quite come off for them. Stars get it away. Dumped into the opposite corner. Here is Preston. Preston looks to go down low. Big battle for it there. Lewis Hall trying to get that puck away for the Stars. Lions get it clear. Could be an icing call, will be an icing call. Jacob Ray's just not quite quick enough to get there. 9:10 gone. And Lions still lead by a goal to nil, Max.
Yeah, neither team really holding possession. Once the Lions get in the zone, they do look good moving that puck around. Just a missed pass at the point. Kind of forced a bit of lost the pressure, unfortunately, in the zone. Meanwhile, Stars do have it after the face-off, after the icing. Working on the half wall, trying to send it to the middle. Lions take over, chip to the line, and out. Bit of a chip and chase in to the corner for the Lions. Stars swing it around to this near side, take their time. Drop off to the D, looking up ice. Long stretch pass, bit of a Hail Mary pass, goes all the way down for icing.
Another good shift there from the debutant, Parson Mervan, really skating hard to try and get that puck into the corner, and you sense I know we're not even 10 minutes into this first period, but he's loving every time he gets out on the ice with this first team.
Yeah, and with the way that he's playing, he's just going to get more and more time, because this is exactly what head coach Matt Bradby wants to see from young players. That eagerness, that hungerness to play.
Face off won by Yokoyama, and the quick shot in from Fisher, and Summerton, I think, gets the second one away there. There was about five bodies between us and the shot there, but save is made by Brown. Oh, 5-3, the Panthers now trail.
I'm guessing an empty net.
I don't know, I've not looked too much, but yeah, probably not far off that. I'll have a look at the end of the first period. We have, you want to see that first goal again, of course you can rewind this live stream, but we will put the video up on our Twitter at the end of the first period, because I'm not going to try and do that while commentating. That's just a recipe for disaster. Here is Fisher on the left, tries to go back into the middle, and again, here we go, you see Summerton chasing that one down with Yokoyama. Yokoyama does really well, tries a little between the legs move, and that one doesn't come off for him. Battles hard though to win the put back in the neutral zone, helped on its way by Wakefield. As Bloor comes out of his net, goes around the boards, here's Fisher, nice backhanded one, but it's kept in by Munro, and Munro gets past a couple. Eventually Yokoyama takes it away from him again, and Lions are 3-on-2 here, and then the Stars come back out off the bench, but here's Summerton playing it back out in front.
Ooh,
and just
wide
from Yokoyama. Lovely move from the Lions. Summerton then tries to drop the puck back and isn't looking when he does so, and that just comes back to the Stars, but tied up again. Here's Fisher, Yokoyama's going to try the wraparound. No, he's not, he's going to go backhand right across the face. Nobody there in a white jersey to poke it home. Here's Summerton out in front, and Brown makes the save, but it's loose out in front and still not covered. And the Stars get it away, and that goes all the way down the ice for an icing. 8:50 to go, and the longer this first period goes on, the more the Lions are starting to get into it.
This top line of Yokoyama, Summerton and Fisher just camped out in the Stars zone and causing them all sorts of problems. Probably a good line matchups coming up from head coach Bradbury, getting them out there in the best opportunities possible.
And a big thank you to Alistair, who's not here this evening, he's watching at home, who's reminded me that's Bidicroft's first senior goal for the Lions one. So a great moment for him as the Lions have it in neutral ice again with Keogh. There's Gloss is screaming from the bench as Billingham were going for a change. Here's Dan Martin feeds it out in front, and Gibbs is there trying to get onto the end of it, and has Brown got a glove on it? Yes, he has. Eventually 8:29 to go, and the Stars look a bit rattled here at the moment, Max.
Brown's just kind of in two minds as to whether to cover something or whether not. He doesn't seem to be gambling too much on just diving on top of a puck and taking a whistle. He's just waiting for the shot to come into either his glove or the chest and hold on there. You mentioned that Gloss was shouting from the bench. I think he wants that puck moved up quickly from the defence rather than holding onto it.
Stars on the left side. Nice diagonal pass. It's a bit long though. Keogh doesn't get it clear, and Elder's right in on Bloor, goes five hole. Lovely goal from Elder to level the scoring here at one apiece. The mistake from Keogh allowed Elder in, and with Bloor not going down to his butterfly, there was a gaping hole in his five hole that Elder was able to wrist shot it through.
Yeah, from my vantage point, I don't want to say I called it, but in my head I thought he's going to have to shoot low here, and Matty Bloor not quick enough to drop into that butterfly, unfortunately.
Game all tied up then. How are the Lions going to respond? Here is Dowd. Dowd up the boards. He was looking for Owen Davis, but Davis couldn't control it. Stars come again. Slightly left of centre shot, and Bloor doesn't hold it, then dives on it, and he still doesn't have it. And
net's off.
Net is off. Fortunately for Bloor, though, he was all out of position. 7:54 to go, first period.
Looking like a bit of a snow angel as more pressure came from through the slot and just kind of slid him out of position even more so. See if we'll have even more problems with that net as the period winds
down. Always doing Nottingham.
The net pegs aren't the greatest.
Face off won by the Stars, but they can't keep it in the zone. Have to get back into their own zone. Skating through three or four Lions players. Good save from Bloor to deny Preston. I suppose the Lions sometimes get caught chasing the puck and you end up with three or four players, maybe two or three, just going after the same puck.
Yeah, just kind of skate, like, they end up seem to be skating with the man rather than challenging him. He just kind of slink through quite easily with a couple of moves.
5-4 now, Panthers.
So that could be...
Could be interesting.
Yeah. Might be worth going back and watching the highlights of that one.
I wonder when the last time... there's still 10 minutes to go as well. I wonder when the last time that the Panthers scored 12 in a weekend was, because I know it's been a while.
I was going to say something really mean, then I'm going to hold my tongue.
Here's Yukiyama around the back of the net, gives it to Ben Marples. Marples with space up the left to try and find Fisher, but... passes wayward, back to Yukiyama. Yukiyama with Cleaves on his right-hand side, tries to go up to Fisher, and it's nipped away from them, and offside called by Astill, the linesman, right in front of us. Moss just a little bit keen to get in. 7:14 to go in this first period.
Both teams looking to kind of force stretch passes and kind of get into the zone quickly, whereas I feel like both teams have done better getting into the zone with a bit of speed rather than forcing them passes in and setting up and getting opportunities that way around.
Nice poke check from Yukiyama. Doesn't quite come to Fisher though. There's confirmation, 11:46 the time of that Stars goals. It's now gone out over the announcement here as they're into the slot again. Is Fisher to Cleaves. He's the Yukiyama up there. Yukiyama just helps it on its way, goes for a change. 6.5 to go first period. It's an interesting mindset that the Lions have kind of got to get themselves in here, where this is a game that, I mean, they don't know this now, they'll know at the end of the first period when they go back into the dressing room, but this is a game that does not matter to the Lions in the slightest as the Stars come back in and it deflects up high. And what I mean by that is that with the best will in the world, over two legs, we're not going to beat Solway in the playoff quarterfinals.
And not in their barn anyway.
And we're guaranteed to finish in 8th in the league now, as here is Grimshaw on the left-hand side, deflection out in front.
I'd be surprised if head coach Bradbury doesn't mention that and just let them play this game out with no kind of thoughts in their head
Is this the sort of thing where he's not going to get too angry if Yukiyama tries one extra move and it doesn't come off and that sort of thing? Because I suppose the key thing here is don't get injured.
Yeah, and build a bit of momentum into those games against the Sharks so you do play at your best.
Here is Mervand again. Mervand fires one right across the... centre of the offensive zone. Forward come the Stars. Emerson has it taken away from him by Keogh. Race battles for that one, but it comes all the way around the boards. Here is Cross, the goal scorer for the Lions. Berehowski helping him out in that scrum at the corner boards on the right hand side of the Lions zone. Here's Keogh again. Turns nicely away from one. Decides to go on his own. Finds Crofts. Crofts can't get it out of the zone, so it's dumped back in again. Back to Keogh. Goes round the boards to Berehowski. Berehowski helps it on its way. Nice work from the Lions there. Through the centre ice logo they come. Chip forward by Race. He's going to have to chase that himself, but Hellens is going to get there first. He tries to come round the left-hand side. The Stars yet again get it clear. Taken away, though, by Summerton at neutral ice. Summerton tries one, he's going to chase that himself and he's going to get there as well. The Stars seem to switch off for a moment there. It comes to Hellens. Hellens goes on to the right hand side. Fisher tries to twist and turn a little bit, doesn't come off for him. Here is Sykes. Sykes to Elder. Elder with the wrist shot, nice blocker save from Bloor. Sykes and Elder linking up again, but Summerton wins the puck back. Here is Keogh. Keogh going for Summerton again, but it's just a bit too far away from him. Lions yet again struggling to get out of their zone as we near 4 minutes to go in this first period. Here is Yokoyama with a bit of speed. He's on his own. Backhand shot is deflected up and does stay in. As it hits the plexiglass right near the top. So 3:50 to go first period. Here is Moss. Nice move away from Dowd as he turns and on a sixpence and throws it back across the centre of the zone. Nobody's there. It's just not quite sitting for the Stars, who've had a good couple of opportunities in the last 90 seconds or so.
Yeah, passes have just been wayward or in the skates and can't take it cleanly for that one-time shot or get themselves set.
Here's Yokoyama again. Two Stars with him for company. It comes to Fisher. Fisher with space to skate into. He's got Yokoyama in support. Here is Fisher. Fisher goes down, finds Yokoyama. Took a little deflection, just took it wide of the left-hand post of Brown. Stars try to come away again. Here's Marples. Marples doesn't look when he's making that pass, and it's been turned over in the offensive zone. Here's Joe Dowdle. That goes round the boards to Grittens. Cleves takes it away from him. Diving clearance from the Lions from Gibbs gets it into neutral ice. 2:40 to go, and the Lions go offside. So with 2:39 to go, it's tied at one. Six-4 Coventry now are beating the Panthers. It's
turning into a bit of a shootout.
And Coast Nut says it was the 2012-13 season in Scotland when Panthers put 10 past 5 and beat the two other teams that weekend. That was the last time they scored like 12 in a weekend.
I'm sure there was some in that 2012-2013 season where Panthers scored 12 in a game. I'm sure of it.
Oh, yeah.
So that kind of counts. Not over a weekend, just did it in one night that time.
Well, that's what I mean. I mean, I know they beat Edinburgh 12-1 or nil. I can't remember now.
Might have been two.
5 years ago. But I don't know if they then also played that weekend on the other
yes.
day. And they might have only scored one. But anyway, we'll comes out. So 2:15 to go in this first period. 1-1 between the Lions and the Stars. Hope you're enjoying this on Lions TV. There will be one next weekend then against the Solway Sharks. And then you've got to go without Lions ice hockey for 5 months. So make the most of it now. Unless, of course, we get to that Final Four weekend. It could happen.
It could happen. It'll be interesting to see. I don't know where we play the.
It's been given away by the Lions right in front of the slot, and his backhand forehand. Bloor makes the save. Triple save from Matty Bloor. And it comes away to Dan Martin. Bloor was scrambling there. Here is Grimshaw. Right hand side. 90 seconds to go, first period. It is out of the zone. Grimshaw goes over to the left hand side for Gibbs, who just dumps it in and goes for a change. Stars bring it away on their right hand side. Here is Helens. Helens gets round one, tries to go short side on Bloor. His post was covered nicely. Down behind the net now, Miles Keogh. Come round to the other side, the Lions, but getting themselves tied up in their own zone, and that one goes straight across the crease. 50 seconds to go in this first period as Lions round the board on the right hand side. That hits the Lions bench, so we'll have a stoppage in play with 42.8 to go.
By the sounds of things, I know we can hear it from this side. I don't know if you can pick it up on the stream, but you can definitely hear Gloss shouting. He'll have plenty to say to the defence at least.
Gloss always has plenty to
say,
let's be honest.
Lions inviting the pressure, not really taking their time and getting their head up, making them passes out of defence.
It's the decision making.
Yes. Yes.
When under pressure, as they win the face off, it's at the half boards. Comes around the back of the net again, Miles Keogh. Up off the boards towards Fisher. Fisher's been dispossessed though. Stars on the left. Long pass forward. That won't be icing. Bloor's going to have to collect it and play it. He gets himself in all sorts of bother. And just about gets away with it. Here is Grittans. Grittans gets away from one, comes across the crease, and a stick from Floor gets it away. Lions just need to get this one clear, and that will do it for the first period. With a second to go, it's fired all the way around the boards, and we are at the end of 20 minutes tied at one here. Billy Crofts with his first senior goal for Lions put them in front at 7:33, but then Michael Elder through Bloor's five hole from the right hand side made it 1-1. Max, your assessment to that opening 20 minutes?
A bit scrappy here and there, but when both teams have got into the zone, they've looked good. They've looked like they've worked and made themselves a nuisance for each other and worked out some good opportunities. Just want to mention that last sequence with Bloor that almost ended up on Steve's Dangits.
I was thinking that way.
Very almost ended up on Steve's Dangits. I almost quoted the man himself as, if you're a goaltender, don't tend
the goal.
Yeah. Jeez. Could have been crazy.
Yeah, so 14 and a half minutes to go until the start of the second period. We're going to take a quick break and we'll see you back in a bit. Second period then is only a few moments away, 1-1 after the first 20 minutes. Shots on goal though after those first 20 minutes, quite low, 8 for the Lions and 10 for the Stars. And in typical NIHL 1 North fashion, the goals haven't been put back and the players are going to have to do it themselves.
No, the referees are out, they're going to be...
The
Men in Stripes tonight will do it for us.
So yes, 1-1. So the Lions are now confirmed in 8th. So the Lions are going up to Solway next Saturday.
That's another coach trip.
Solway apparently wanted it on the Sunday, but because we just cannot get ice on a Saturday because of public skating and the like, they've got to come to us on the Sunday. And as far as I'm aware, the Vipers have been moved, and I think it's still a 7:15 face-off.
Oh.
But I'm not 100% sure on that, don't quote me.
If the Vipers, it might be an earlier face-off with the Vipers being moved.
Yeah, might be. I'm not sure. I don't know if there was a junior before the Vipers.
Potentially.
I don't know. All I know is that the Vipers have moved, but I don't know when that game is now. So, yeah. But that'll be next Sunday, Lions Live, final one of the season. And it will be the final Lions Live of the season, whatever happens, because at finals weekend, we're not the ones doing the coverage.
No, unfortunately. I'm not even sure where the playoff weekend is held.
NIHL 1 is Altrincham.
Oh, that's okay.
Somewhere you know well.
Yeah, I know how cold it is as well.
Opening face-off of the second period, won by the Stars, and yes, it is very, very cold. I've not had to go there yet this season. And in fact, I won't now. But
I'm taking a heater next time I go up.
There used to be one and it broke from overuse as the Stars
shocking.
Go offside 16 seconds in to this second period. I did change it to second period on the scoreboard, that's fine. A couple of shout outs to do at the start of the second period. Georgie, Grant and Maisie, and also Paul Lloyd, Becca Lloyd, Mickey Young and Phil Mood. It's the Lions with speed with Fisher on the left hand side, Summerton coming across to help him, but Stars are able to just sort it out in the defensive zone. Win possession of the puck back, long pass forward is deflected by Sykes up into the face of Elder. He seems to be okay, and then it's been won by Sykes again on the left hand side, nipped away from him by Marples, who cuts inside towards centre. Yukiyama just beyond him. Stars with possession back once more and trying to feed it towards the middle, and Matty again has not got a glove on it, and give Stars the rebound. And hear the shout from Gloss as well, out in front, and Matty's scrambling in his crease as his skate thundered against the eye, and heard it from here, and just not having the greatest of games. He was unhappy with his performance in the dressing room when I went in there at the end of the first period. As Cleves tidies up for the Lions, gets it clear, and Yukiyama's going to win the race to this. There's not going to be an icing. Summerton in the middle, but some great defensive work from the Stars there.
Kind of in that position, you want Yukiyama to be a little bit more greedy and go for a shot on goal, if not hold on to possession
almost
as well.
Almost go for that kind of low pad rebound.
Yeah,
sort
exactly.
Of.
Or even circle around the back of the net and just hold some pressure in the zone. Because when that line has been on the ice and in the zone, they've caused some serious trouble in that first period.
The top line of the Lions is causing the Stars problem, which is full credit to Summerton as well, who's not long been in
yes.
the squad. And looks to be a terrific player. Looking forward to seeing more of him in the coming seasons as the Stars win the draw. Go around the back of the net, here's Spraggan. Spraggan gets it back again, left hand side, down towards the goal line, thinks about going short side, does go short side. Matty Bloor does get it covered, and we're a second shy of 2 minutes gone in this middle period. Still 1-1, and a very exciting game of hockey here at the National Ice Centre. I just hope that it continues to be this way. And what we've seen so often with the Lions, of course, is a quick fire like 1-2-3 against them, and then the game's
yes.
dead in like 5 minutes.
One thing they have done very well is, yes, they gave up that goal to go 1-1. They haven't
defensive blue line again, and the Lions on the left-hand side. Here's with Miles Keogh. Miles Keogh drops it in, and Gibbs wants it. Then Grimshaw tries to go short side, and Gibbs was smacking his stick on the ice, wanting that puck across, and there was nobody around him. But Stars get away with it and come up into neutral ice themselves. Now onto the right-hand side with Emerson. And Emerson has it taken away from him. Opportunity for the Lions to come forward again. And now same thing again. Space on the right-hand side. Dan Martin, it just comes off the stick. And it isn't able to come through to Martin. Lucas Dowdle gets it clear. And it looks like we might have a little bit of a breather again, Max. I can go back to let you finish your point. Sorry
about
that.
That's fine. I'm going to let you keep going with the play-by-play because it looks like it's going to ramp up yet again.
Round the back of the net line, steal it. Coming out in front, and Stars are just able to reach out a stick and get it away. There is Wilcox. Wilcox just advances it slightly. Lions win it back on the red line. Stars then get it back once more, though. Enter the zone. Shot is only gloved by Bloor at the second attempt. 3:13 gone in the second period. A little bit of pushing and shoving. We do now have a break, and I can go back to Max.
Well, it's nice to see Matty hold on to that one. He did have to juggle it a little bit. And I was just thinking before that play stopped that the game hasn't been overly physical, even though we have a little bit of pushing and shoving
there.
Haven't had a penalty yet. So neither team yet tested on the power play or penalty kill.
Puck is in Lions possession. Here is Jacob Race. Race with options, decides to go round the boards looking for Davis. Davis has it jump up above, ahead of him. Here is Wall. And Stars get possession of the puck back, and it's away from one is Sykes. Yokoyama is going to get there first, though. He tries to go round the boards. Lions can't keep control of it, and Joe Dowdle is going to help that one down the line. Over onto the right side, shot in, is padded into the corner by Bloor. Just shy of four gone in the second period. Still Stars in the zone, dumped down low by Grittans, and then out in front of Bloor again as Stars look to get a high quality look in front of net.
Yokoyama and Sykes getting into it in front of the net as well.
Bloor makes the catch. 15:43 to go, second period.
See if anything more of that comes of it during the rest of this game.
So the according to Alistair, who is at home and able to look at the live table, playoffs have been determined. Solway Sharks against the Nottingham Lions, Billingham Stars take on the Blackburn Hawks, Whitley Warriors against the Deeside Dragons, and the Solihull Barons against the Widnes Wild. Ties to be played next weekend. As I said, our home leg will be on the Sunday. And the aim for Lions next Saturday, of course, is the Stars edge towards the crease. And that puck now comes away. And here is Yukiyama. Yukiyama with a bit of speed drops the puck, leaves it behind him. He's able to get it through to Summerton, who just can't quite control it. Summerton chases it himself, though, and keeps it. Fisher gets pinned, and the Stars are able to take it away from him. Summerton. Down low, Stars bring it away again. They're 2-on-1. Here is Walls, and that one goes wide and will come back into the neutral zone. Munro. He'll just ring that one around the boards. Robert Oxley goes to chase that one for the Lions. Goes down in a heap. Gets up and wins it again, but can't clear it out of the zone. Stars still with it. Nice move around from one and around from two. And that nobody knows where that is. So it's down low in the high slot area. That went high up into the air and everybody lost it, including the referee.
And myself.
Yeah, and us. And here's Yukiyama again. And Lions with the opportunity to attack with a bit of speed. Yukiyama takes the shot just wide. And that's not going to stay in the zone. It's going to come all the way down the ice. Cross to have to go and chase it. Cross goes down. Referee's arm stays down, though. And Lions are able to get it into the neutral zone. But Grittans just takes it back for the Stars and goes over to the right-hand side. Helped on its way, there will be no icing. Cross has to chase in, has to try and get there ahead of Hall. And Hall just wins the muscle race, but the loose puck comes to Gibbs. Gibbs off the boards, can't get it out of the zone again, Lions, and that's fallen for the Stars. Loose out in front of Bloor, but goes into the corner. Just over six gone, second period, as it's won by Gibbs. Gibbs tries to get around the bend on the blue line, but Jackson just beats him to it. Here's Hall fighting for it. Grittans helps it forward. Preston on the left. The Stars really limiting the Lions at the moment, but here they come with Grimshaw. Grimshaw forced well wide. That goes behind the net. Big battle for it, though. Dan Martin staying with it. Lions now trying to have a bit of time inside the Stars zone. Bit of puck luck, doesn't quite find Grimshaw, though, and Emerson is able to feed it over to the right hand side, and Stars get it out and then into their bench. 13:09 to go. So what's the mindset now, Max, with those playoff matchups determined? So essentially now neither side has got anything to play for in this.
Just that momentum and that kind of belief in yourself that you can play a playoff style from all the way.
Yeah, but does this turn into a playoff practice now? Do you treat this like a playoff game?
I think you've got to get into that mindset as early as possible. And with this being the last game to do so, you've got a period and a half nearly for you to get into that style.
I mean, the key thing for the Lions is going to be next Saturday up in Solway, as here's an opportunity for the Stars to break away. So I'll break off. Here is Moss. Moss just forced around the back of the net. Goes over to the left-hand side. Lions are able to briefly gain control of it with Wilcox. And they are able to get it clear back into the neutral zone. The key for the Lions next Saturday in Solway is just going to be keeping it to a scoreline where, as opportunity again is high and wide, and Lions need to... really rely on Matty Bloor to get some gloves on this as the puck comes across. Keep the scoreline next Saturday to a scoreline where you give yourself the opportunity here, yes, for anything to happen. No, one goal, two goals, maybe even three goals, but don't come back from Solway on the Saturday 5 goals behind.
I think the last time we played last season we played them in the playoffs, we kept it within one and then went and played them up in Solway, and then the scoreline unfortunately got a little bit out of control in the last two periods.
Now that's got to be the key for the Lions. Obviously last year, of course, only 8 teams in the league, so despite the Lions really not finding any sort of form until the back half of the season, they qualified for the playoffs despite finishing bottom. This year it's not the case, as Stars come up the right hand side. And a bit of puck luck there for them. Just runs away last minute. Arm goes up. We're going to have a penalty. As play continues, and then as Summerton touches the puck, We will have the stoppage. It's a holding call with 11:39 to go in the second period.
Can't be upset with that penalty, really. A penalty you kind of have to take, otherwise you're going to give up an opportunity right in front of Matty Bloor with that pass across the crease from the corner.
There's Xander Cleaves with a penalty, who's now having a discussion with Fraley, the referee. And that's a good discussion between player and referee there. He may not disagree, but doesn't go screaming all in the referee's face and getting himself in misconduct. Has a discussion, sees it from the referee's point of view, nods his head, goes off to the penalty box. So power play for the Stars then. First opportunity we get to see any of the special teams for either side. As the Stars then move it around the offensive zone, looking for that ideal shot. Here is Grittans, goes over to the right. Nice work from Miles Keogh just to disrupt the offensive play for a moment, and then it just bobbles over a stick, allows the Lions to go in. Can they get it clear? It's all tied up. Then they do get it clear, and Yokoyama's chasing this one. Yokoyama's winning the race to this one. Netminder comes out, plays it to Grittans, and now Yokoyama's a bit too far up the ice. Grittans comes in on the left-hand side. Just over of this penalty has expired to Cleaves. Nothing of any danger on Matty Bloor's net so far. Nice penalty kill from the Lions, forcing Billingham to the outside. 1 minute gone. High slot, low in, and takes a deflection, and Bloor gets a cover on it. So we've got 57 seconds of the penalty to go. Nice kill so far from the Lions.
So far so good. Gibbs putting good pressure on, forcing the Stars to the outside. Yokoyama almost got a touch on the goalie's clearance as well.
Somebody won the 50-50, but I didn't hear who. But it was somebody that was here.
It sounded like a Stars fan.
Yeah, it did sound like a Stars fan. Somebody from the Stars fans won the 50-50. Here is Galloway through the centre ice logo, over to the right hand side. Is Preston. Galloway is back to Helens. Galloway again, down low, nice passing move, and just bobbles over the stick at the last minute. 30 seconds to go on this kill, and they've been forced into the neutral zone. Race doing nicely there with the stick. Here is Galloway again. Galloway leaves it off, and Bloor makes the glove save from Preston. 15 seconds to go, sorry. Did you notice that the pixels are broken on the scoreboard?
It's frustrating. At least the main time isn't. But I know there's some ways around the rinks where you don't know if it's an 8 or a 5 or a 3 or a 7 or a 6.
How long have we actually got there? But no, yeah. 15 seconds to go on the penalty to Cleaves, who's now stood up in the box ready to come back out. And a really good kill so far from the Lions, who then ring it round the boards all the way down the ice. And that's going to be won by Fisher. Fisher's going to get there first and tie the puck up, and it's come out in front for the Lions. Opportunity for the shot, and it just hits the leg from Summerton, and there is a holding call
against the Stars.
And just as Cleaves comes back out onto the ice, Lions now go on the power play, and it's Roland Gritton's going into the box. And I just wonder, Summerton had a great opportunity, and he hesitated well and was just unlucky there. He's still looking, as far as I'm aware, for his first goal as well.
Yes.
I just wonder if that, once he gets the first one, he strikes me as the kind of player, he gets his first senior goal, they will start coming. But at the minute, it might just be tensing up ever so slightly.
And it looks like he's got the confidence of his linemates as well, with Fisher and Yokoyama, to give him them opportunities.
Yeah. Here is Grimshaw. Grimshaw goes to Gibbs. Lions on the power play here. Back to Grimshaw. Grimshaw shoots, that's high and wide, but comes to Summerton. First line power play time for him as well. Yokoyama shoots, and Gibbs just can't quite get that one away. Here is Grimshaw. Nice fake away from one. Saucer pass over to Summerton. Lovely pass there from Grimshaw. Yokoyama back to Grimshaw again. 30 seconds gone. Yokoyama wants it. Grimshaw looking. Grimshaw shoots and it's loose. And Fisher takes a couple of whacks at it. And eventually it comes into the glove of Brown. And Lions will have the offensive zone face-off. 8:56 to go, second period. 1:19 to go on the power play. Nice power play so far from the Lions.
So far, so good. Grimshaw playing a brilliant pass across.
That was lovely.
Being a great great provider of the pass. Yokoyama making himself available in all sorts of situations. At the point, creeping down, driving to the net. And Fisher with a couple of bites off the cherry, just couldn't get it past the pads.
Sticking with that first line at the moment as the Stars win the face-off, try to get it clear. Yokoyama keeps it in, is under a lot of pressure. Can the Lions keep it in? No, they can't. And that will do their... they'll probably take the change on that. No, they don't. So still that first line out. Here is Summerton. Summerton with space to skate into, gives it to Gibbs. Gibbs back to Summerton. Needs a bit of support. The Summerton, and it's just poked away from him by Elder. Lions go down the ice to collect with Grimshaw into the second of the 2 minutes power play now. Still nothing that's really troubled Brown too much. Here is Gibbs again. Long, long shift for this first line power play. There's Gibbs on the right hand side. Yokoyama gives it back to Gibbs. Back to Yokoyama again. Fisher wants it on this right hand side. Yokoyama stays with it. Gives it back to Gibbs, but it's just on the wrong side for him. And the Stars will be able to get this one clear, and they lob it all the way down the ice. I think it hits Grimshaw. And Yokoyama now against his opposite number, Emerson. Yokoyama gives it to Gibbs. Gibbs helps it on its way to Summerton. Summerton thinks about the shot, does shoot, forces the blocker save, gets it back on his backhand. Into the final 10 seconds of the power play. Here's Yokoyama. Yokoyama to Grimshaw. Grimshaw gets away from one, goes down. Referee's arm stays down, though. That'll do it for the power play, and Yokoyama, who's really tired, has got to go and get to that one, and isn't going to get there in time, and Grittans is going to get there first. Yokoyama gets it back, and this is a long, long shift for the Lions. They played the full 2 minutes of the power play. Now they're still out there as Grittans battles for it, gets it out in front of Bloor, and now the Lions are desperate for a stoppage so they can change personnel. Grittans again fresh after a 2 minute rest. Dangling all round in the offensive zone. Lions now have the puck again, and they do manage to get at least a partial change. Race out there now alongside Owen Davis. Still Yokoyama out there. About a 3 minute shift for him now as the Stars play it out in front. Lions get themselves all in a bother in their own slot. Race can't get it clear now. Now he does, but that's just going to be an icing call. And still out there is Yokoyama on about a 3.5 minute shift now.
Well, he got caught out playing. He plays the point back on the defensive side of that power play. And having to go back to chase down that stretch pass ahead, which I thought would have been gone for ice, but obviously the Stars player out the box beats him to it. And just compounding themselves and putting themselves under more pressure, just can't get that puck onto a clean stick and away, just getting tied up in skates.
I mean, Lions aim now, win the face-off, get the puck out the zone and down the other end of the ice for not an icing call. But of course, being in the second period, they've almost got to get it down to the goal line to be able to get a change.
And at the moment, they've still got four forwards on there, with Yokoyama kind of floating around as a defensive forward.
That one bobbles high up and over the net, back in again from the Stars. This is, I think the Stars can see this as an opportunity to capitalise as Finlay Wall just gets the puck but can't control it. Right hand side, down low now. Stars just trying to find a way through as that's blocked before it gets to Bloor. Bloor then makes the save, and now Lions will get that change that they were so desperately needed. 6:06 to go. Yokoyama's getting in a bit of a discussion. In fact, Yokoyama's not really doing a great deal. And Chris Sykes is giving him a few face washes.
I believe the arms up from the referee, there's going to be a call on the play. It might be Yokoyama that's going to the box. In fact, he's taking someone with him at least.
Yokoyama is going as well. Yokoyama going as well as Sykes. I can't say that there was a lot in that roughing call.
No.
It strikes me as one that Fraley's trying to stamp it out. You do anything, you're in the box. And of course, that being Zach is now going for it and giving it all the talk in the penalty box.
Sounds like a Shakespeare sonnet that he's reciting.
Does a bit, doesn't it? So 2 minute penalties then, 4-on-4.
Be interesting to see how the teams match up 4-on-4. Both teams look fast going through the neutral zone and into the offensive zone either way.
So it's the Stars with it then, on the left hand side. As Ball gets a block or two, it is going to come to Grimshaw. Three Lions players behind the net collecting it. They do manage to get it into neutral ice. Here is Grimshaw. Grimshaw tries to cut into the middle and fires one just wide. Here's Gibbs. Gibbs plays it down low, and Lions playing with three on the blue line at the moment. Now Gibbs comes forward. Still the Stars able to get it away with Preston. Preston, left hand side, round the back of the net and looking for that pass out in front. There's too many legs in the way. And Gibbs is able to come away with the Lions. With a bit of speed now, Lions, but Oxley just backhands it to nobody, and it's 2-on-1 for the Stars. Is Grittans. Emerson can't go with him, wants a change instead. Wonder if Emerson's ever so slightly hurt there as we go into 5 minutes to go in the second period. Still 1-1, no goals in this middle 20 so far, inside 5 minutes to go. Great game of hockey we've got here at the National Ice Centre. 40 seconds to go of 4-on-4. Stars on the right-hand side. Get around the bend as well, looking for that pass out in front just to try and disrupt Bloor. Now play it over to the right. And that one goes wide of Bloor's net. He was scrambling for a moment, but I think he had it covered as the puck goes down low again. The Stars have had the advantage since that Lions power play, where they're on the ice for 2 minutes, just got themselves tired, and I think that's forcing Matt Bradbury a little bit to use his lower lines just to recover his top line a little bit. As on the right hand side, the Stars, the shot is deflected, then it comes off the back of the post, and then Bloor makes a terrific glove save as Yokoyama and Sykes come back out onto the ice, and the linesman just stays between them until they go all the way back to the bench.
The conversation,
having a bit of a discussion with Sykes.
Conversation continues between them as well, and with going down to four on four and also having the power play and then the penalty kill, it's forced Matt Bradbury to play his top players more than he probably would have liked to.
Yeah, so that's what I was saying. So in order to then recover them in the last couple of minutes, he's had to play the bottom six more.
Somerton was back out there for that 4-on-4 as well.
He's got young legs, he can manage it. here is Fisher for the Lions, left hand side, diagonal pass, at least gets into the neutral zone, and Lions have control of it again. Here is Race with a shot straight into the logo of Tom Brown. 3:48 to go, middle period. And it doesn't have to be high scoring to be a great game of hockey, as we're proving here.
Yeah, you've seen a little bit of line juggling there as Race took a quick shift with Fisher and Somerton. Now Yokoyama back out for this face-off.
Cleaves keeps it in the zone, takes a shot that's blocked at source, gets it back. That one's blocked at source as well. Somerton doesn't quite get there first. Lions, though, do keep it in the zone. And Somerton is the one to chase it from one side of the ice to the other, and that's going up, and that is in our equipment cupboard, I believe. Or it's very, very close to the equipment cupboard anyway. 3:34 to go. There you go, if you're ever wondering where the equipment cupboard for us was at the National Ice Centre, it's ever there in the left corner.
Usually where the Christmas tree is.
Yeah. 3:34 then, second period, still 1-1. Shots on goal feel relatively even in this second period as well. So I hope you are enjoying this penultimate Lions Live of the season. Here is Grittans on the left-hand side. There's Moss, goes over to the right, back to Grittans. He goes back to Moss again. Now on the left, fed back out in front, Grittans, and fired it up, hit the glass. Puck moving around nicely for the Stars now. Grittans goes over to the right, Bloor makes the save by letting it hit his chest and then diving on the rebound. 2:58 to go, middle period.
Of the two teams, it seems that the Stars have settled down quicker in this second period than the
The thing that I'm seeming to find is that the Stars aren't having the better of the game, but the Lions have a 3 or 4 minute spell where they're really dominant and really push it.
Yeah, the game.
And then they fall back into kind of almost inviting a bit of Stars pressure.
Yeah. Coming in waves of the Lions.
Yeah, well, that one's plucked out of the air and falls kindly for the Stars as they try and get a shot away. Lions with a bit of puck luck there just to divert it wide. 2:40 to go. Back to the right point. That shot was blocked at source, and that's up and into the matting, well over the glass. Of course, there's no net that end. And 2:36 to go, still 1-1.
I mean, regardless of the net this end, a couple of times this season we've seen it going up,
well,
and up and over
true.
There.
Well, it did land in the ceiling at one point, didn't it?
Looking up now, I remember there's one. I can see one stuck in the wall.
Yeah, that nobody can ever get down.
No.
One day it's just going to fall down.
I hope not.
No, I hope not, but at some point.
It might.
Here is Yokoyama. Yokoyama around the bend at the right face-off circle. It's taken away from him as he tried to backhand it towards Fisher. Summerton tries to help it on its way. Back to Spraggan now. Spraggan and Stars offside. Sykes a bit too eager. 2:13 to go. Yeah, it is right up.
I know. It takes some.
I want to know how somebody got it up there.
Well, it ramped up off a. From what I remember, it ramped up off a stick.
Oh, is this why you were here?
Yeah. Because two have gone out that well, around that high when I've been doing commentary. I can't remember if it was Lions 2 or Lions 1. But yeah, ramped up off a stick from the point, and it was obviously hit with some serious force because it stuck in there and travelled a fair distance.
It did, yeah. Yeah, I don't think that's a feature of the National Ice Centre now. Lions then trying to get it out of their zone. Here is Gibbs. Gibbs has got Race on his right-hand side, racing towards the net, and just a bit too far in front of him for him to poke something there. Race then tries to help it on its way round, and starts able to regain possession. Inside the final 2 minutes of this middle period, here is Gibbs. Gibbs is on his own, so he needs to try and take a shot. Instead tries a move, and he's just kind of held up a bit, and Stars will win it back again. Preston coming forward, gives it to Hall inside one, nicely taken away. Gibbs again doesn't have support, cuts inside to the high slot. Does Gibbs takes a shot, but stick gets in the way from Andrew Munro. Here is Gibbs once more, and that's just taken away from him in the slot, and there's a penalty coming against the Stars. And holding his face is Gibbs. Hit to the head. Just the 2 minutes though, no blood as far as I can see. That's Munro. It is a hit to the head against Munro. Lions power play to finish this second period. Anthony says, if anything at the National Ice Centre falls down before anything falls down at Basingstoke, he's falling off his chair. And it's a happy 18th birthday to Sam Dowd, the number 6 for the Stars, who starts their penalty kill by clearing it all the way down the ice for Bloor, who doesn't control it again. And here is Yokoyama. Yokoyama with speed gets away from two. Lions have got to stay onside. They do. Yokoyama almost goes coast to coast. Summerton keeps it in, plays it back down low. Gibbs is going to get a hold of this one. Into the final minute of this second period as the Stars yet again get it clear. Summerton doesn't know where it is. And he's done really well there actually to get the puck away from Sykes, not knowing where it was for a moment. So it's going to be a straight race, and then one of the Stars has lost an edge, and that allows Lions to be 5-on-2 here as the Stars take a change. Surely the Lions have got to do something with this out in front.
Yes.
Scores! The Lions do something with it. 2-1 with 27.7 seconds to go, and Tyler Summerton gets his goal for the Lions that he so truly deserves. 2-1 with 27.7 seconds to go in the second. And the Lions are desperately trying to get that puck.
I'm a little bit lost for words. Summerton getting absolutely mobbed by his power play line mates, and deservedly so. As just off screen, probably you're seeing Miles Keogh just
taking a step off. We're just having a stoppage here. Referee not happy.
Are they trying to clear the penalty?
Yeah.
It's not an easy thing to work this scoreboard. But a great play from the Lions. Blown tyre from one of the Stars, and they're in 5-on-2 and making
and that's
pay.
Up and into the supporters. Face-off is one. Lions get it. 18 seconds to go in the period. They're tying it up, going down low. Brown's not going to go and collect it. Fisher's going to get there first. 10 seconds to go. The Lions bench want them to get a shot on, but they're just going to tie it up in the corner. That's going to do it for the second period. And the Lions find themselves in at the end of 40 minutes, leading by 2-1. Tyler Summerton with his first goal for the Lions, putting them ahead with 27.7 seconds to go in that second period. And what a second period that was, Max Artis.
I'm still lost for words on that Summerton goal. Like, I'll be honest, it wasn't pretty. It wasn't probably one that won't live too long in the highlight bank, but well worked.
He's not going to care, is he?
No, he shouldn't.
He's not going to care at all.
And he shouldn't. He was Johnny on the spot and slammed it home to put the Lions ahead going into the third period.
It strikes me, as I said that, I mean, I only said it, 15 minutes or so ago, yes, that when he gets the first one, that might just completely open it up. But, yeah, right, 14 minutes to go in that, 40 minutes to go in the second intermission. We'll take another short break. Billingham Stars make their way back out on to the ice then. Lions leading by 2-1. Lions just queuing up away from the door. And before we get the final period underway, an apology from us.
Yes.
Because that wasn't Tyler Summerton's first Lions 1 goal. That was actually his third. Apparently he scored at the arena game where you were busy goal judging and it must have been down the other end and I was at work.
Yep.
And then the other one must have been away because you don't remember commentating on it and
no.
I don't remember clipping the highlights on it.
No. But what we can say is this is the first time in the CCM ring that's his first goal.
That's true. For Lions 1.
For Lions 1, yes. First goal in this ring.
Unless the other goal was also but I don't think it was. Lions back out onto the ice and they lead by 2-1. They are being outshot 21-14 though. But they find themselves on the right side of the scoreboard. Now you said, Max, when we were talking just before we turned the microphones back on, that it's very important this next goal.
Yeah, I mean, although they are being outshot, not a ton, but enough.
Not as much as they have been at points this season.
But I don't feel like they've been outchanced. A couple of bounces, luckily for Matty Bloor, going the right way at the post rather than in between them. At the other end, a couple of flashes through the crease. Their goalie, equally not as on his game as probably he feel he should be. So, an exciting 20 minutes and potentially more. In this game.
It feels like a game that will go further than 60.
Yeah, you did say that, but then
to me anyway, it just feels like a game that will go further. So, I mean, that's another thing. I mean, for all the straight away from the face-off, here comes Fisher on his backhand down low, takes a quick shot that is covered by Brown after 7 seconds. I mean, we've been saying it throughout the game day, but for all of the shots that Matty Bloor isn't holding on to, he's above 950 save percentage for the night as it stands.
Yeah, he's not been it's not been a conventional style of goaltending that he's used tonight, but it's got the job done.
It doesn't matter, does it really?
As long as it's not going
done.
In the back
here
of the net.
Fisher tries to feed it back out into the middle. Cleaves can't keep it in. The Fisher has to clear out of the zone, gives the Stars the chance to come away. And here is Moss straight down the middle, and Bloor squeezes it between his pads. Wasn't sure where it was for a moment, but we'll have another stoppage. 26 seconds gone in this final period. Line still up by a goal.
A little bit nervy that the Stars player was allowed to go straight down Main Street on almost like a partial breakaway. Bloor obviously had it covered all the way to the post. Bit of equipment check.
Now just taking his time sorting his equipment back out again.
It's not like he had a whole period break to figure that out.
It might just be a case as Sykes tries to go through, it takes a deflection and Fisher can help it up on its way towards Yukiyama, who plucks it out of the air, and he's got Summerton in support. Yukiyama goes across trying to find Summerton, but he's a bit too close to Brown, who makes the pad save. I wonder if that from Matty Bloor was just the opportunity to just give the Lions a little bit more time just to set themselves and calm down at the start of the third period, as that comes down and Ryan Keogh is going to collect that one. Over to the left hand side, back to Keogh again, looking for an outlet pass, and that one will come off. It's going to come to Yukiyama all the way on the offensive blue line. Yukiyama coming front to Fisher, back out to Summerton. Summerton shoots and forces a right pad save out of Brown. Round the back looking for Yukiyama. Too many Stars players there though. 1:20 gone, final period. Line still up by two as Gibbs takes it away on the blue line. He's got no support though. It does fall through to Grimshaw. Grimshaw's shot has a stick in the way. He goes harmlessly into the corner. Minute and a half gone, final period. Back behind their own net, here is McGoughlin. McGoughlin loses out. Lions win possession back once more. Options down at the point, but McGoughlin ties it up. It comes back to Dan Martin. Dan Martin back to Grimshaw. Grimshaw around the back of the net on his backhand, looking for that outlet pass. Cycling back down in front, cycles to the outside again. Still with it, Grimshaw, as he tries to go back onto his forehand again. He goes down. There's a bit of a scrum up again. No, Grimshaw still with it. And eventually finds a pass out to the right point to Billy Crofts. Billy Crofts down low to Dan Martin. Penalty coming against the Stars. Lions are going to go back onto the power play again. Back to the right point to Crofts. And now we're going to have the stoppage in play. We'll have the power play to the Lions. 17:41 to go. They're up by a goal.
Sorry if I distracted you there a little bit, Chris, but when Matty Bloor went to the bench, you know, they couldn't decide. Well, Bloor was shouting all the way, who's going to jump, who's going to go. Yukiyama was in the middle of two players and was scrambling to try and get over the ball. Somebody else jumped on instead.
We ended up with too many men.
We almost ended up with a penalty for too many men on the ice on a delayed penalty call.
Ethan McGoughlin taking the penalty for the Stars. So Lions back onto the power play. Here is Yukiyama. Yukiyama moving the puck around. Grimshaw's out there as well. Summerton, lovely pass over to the other side, and that's a comfortable save though from Brown, who saw that one all the way. The Lions have got to be careful because Stars are leaving one player up, just looking for that break as round the back of the net they come. Summerton with the shot, and Zach Yukiyama thought that was in. The slashing call against McGoughlin. Lions then have had 33 seconds of the power play, so plenty of time left on it. 17:07 to go. A power play goal here would do wonders for the Lions.
Yeah, absolutely wonders. And see if Fisher can win this clean back again. He does.
Fisher wins the face off. Summerton plays it down back to Fisher again. Fisher goes back to Summerton, who just loses it a little bit, but then takes the shot. It's blocked at source, and Stars will be able to bring this one away. But nice work from Summerton to force Grittans backwards. Nice high forecheck. It's a long looping one back. Yukiyama playing the extra defenceman. Collects it, gives it to Summerton. Nice pass to Summerton over to Grimshaw. Grimshaw can't keep it in the zone. Stars will have it in neutral ice, back into their own zone. Long pass forward, kind of a dump in. Gibbs should get there first and does. Slightly loses an edge though, then completely loses an edge. Does find Cleaves. Cleaves though can't control it the way he would like. Gibbs back up on his feet, gets it again. Gibbs dangerously goes in front of Matty Bloor, and the shot from Emerson took a deflection, and that was almost a howler for the Lions. 26 seconds on the power play to go, and again this time Summerton goes in front of the net rather than behind. Here is Yokoyama over all three lines, takes the shot and it's blocked at source, comes to Preston. Just 10 seconds to go now on the penalty to McGoffin. There's a little bit of a breakdown in communication, but Race finds Yokoyama. Yokoyama on the left hand side, playing it out in front, rebound, where is it?
Oh, it's under the pad.
Berehowski can't quite poke it past Brown, who gets something on it. 15:40 to go. This is getting a very exciting game, isn't it?
Yeah, and it's another young spark from the Lions coming up through the ranks in Berehowski, getting that opportunity in front.
It was almost a giveaway there. Lions still with it as Mervan plays it down low. Stars are back to full strength now. 5-on-5 hockey, nice pass forward. It's just not quite controlled by Galloway as the Lions fight for it. Here is Ethan Wilcox. Wilcox up the board, and Mahan's going to chase that one. It's not quite going to get there. It will be an icing call. 15:10 to go. It's just shy of 5 minutes gone in this final period. Of course, don't forget as we tick towards the end of this game that we do need your man of the match nominations in. So either Lions or Stars, let us know, and you'll at the end of the game get to see if you're right as Moss tries to play it forward, but Race is going to get there, play it out. Lions will get a change. A partial change at least. Puck didn't quite go as far as Race intended. All the way around the boards it comes. As Stars try to go short side on Bloor, now try to go the long way around on Bloor, but he covers the near hand post on both occasions. Berehowski gets it down the net, down the ice. Lions will go for another change. Stars on the right hand side. Long pass forward across a couple of lines. Left-hand side they are, looking for that short side. Forced all the way around the back of the net. Here is Grittans. Grittans with a couple of options. Decides the best option is centre of the blue line. Trying to get back to Grittans and he just can't quite get it to sit for him. It did take a slight deflection off a line stick. And that one takes a deflection across the crease. It's another one of those spells, Max, we've been talking about where the Lions had a good 2 or 3 minutes. Now it's back kind of all Stars again for a moment. Lions soaking up pressure as they get it out of the zone. Stars in the ascendancy at the moment. 6:15 gone in this final period. Lions still leading by 2-1. Summerton with the go-ahead goal at the moment as Stars come on the left-hand side with speed cutting inside. Still going as Sprenger takes the shot just over the top left corner of Bloor's net. Here's Hellens. Hellens looking for that deflection. That's not going to stay in the zone. It's going to come all the way down.
Wholesale change from the Lions. Bit ill-advised.
They get away with it, thanks to a poor touch from Spragan. And Yokoyama collects. Yokoyama then gets caught up behind the net with two Stars players trying to take it away from him. Elder gets the puck now. Here is Hellens. Fisher helps it on its way out of the zone, and that just allows Lions to regroup, but it is going to be an icing with 7:04 gone in this final period. 12:56 to go. Clock is winding down, but taking an awfully long time to do so, Max.
Yeah, Stars turning up the pressure and just turning up the heat.
It's keeping a game the Lions you feel the there's more goals in.
Yeah, somebody's going to break through eventually. It's just who's going to crack first. And with the Lions making a few little schoolboy errors, like skating in front of the crease instead of behind the back of the goal.
Keogh loses an edge. Does that give possession back to the Stars? He gets lucky with it. is able to win it back, then plays it off a Billingham skate, comes around the boards to Yokoyama. Linesman just about gets out of the way, but passes wayward. Stars have possession again. Nice drop pass, looking for the pass out on the right hand side for Preston. It's just a little bit in front of him. Miles Keogh will get there first. Goes, tries to go backhand again. Maybe should have just gone forehand round the boards to clear this puck out of the zone. Lions, you feel, need a stoppage and a bit of a change in the momentum at the moment, as Keogh wins it back again. Helps it on the boards round, looking for Yokoyama. Yokoyama is beaten to it by Gritans. Gritans tries to play it into the middle, and Summerton gets it away to Yokoyama. Now this Lions top line can spread their legs again. Back to Fisher, who forces a good save out of Brown, and 8:06 gone.
Not sure if that caught Brown in the mask. He's kind of shaking his head just a little bit. Not sure if that's going to be anything.
I think he was
going
right
forward
up there.
May have just come off the chin of the mask.
Face off then on the left-hand side as the Lions look at it. Race is contesting it. And the Lions still 2-1 up. Said, keep getting your man of the match nominations in. Here is Gritans. Gritans trying to play that pass through, and Marple's really nice diving play. And back through, here is Joe Dowdles. Yes, keep getting your man of the match nominations in. Lucas Sheldon, says Sheldon for man of the match. Not quite sure about that one. As Lions still with that slender lead, 11:20 to go. Gritans trying to go through three or four players, goes down, referee's arm stays down, and then he loses out, and Lions though can't get it out of the zone as Finlay Wall doesn't get it clear enough, and Stars out in front. That's a bobbling puck around everywhere. Nine gone, final period, Lions still up by a goal. Here is Walls for a couple and wide, and is Bloor going to cover that against his post? He is. 10:53 to go. Lions still up by 2-1.
Stars looking more and more comfortable in the zone as this period winds on. Lions looking a bit more scrambly and just kind of rushing on the puck just a little bit. They need to get back to their composure in the first two periods, which has given them the one goal lead.
So after a bit of a tie-up and sticks flying everywhere, it's the Stars that have it. Nice block by Dan Martin from the shot from Helens. Helens with it again, taken away though. And the Lions get it clear. I mean, it's going to be an icing call as Josh Dow clears it all the way down the ice. But 10:33 to go. It at least gives them another face-off.
Anthony Russell from Banners on the Walls going with Billy Crofts and the Stars netminder for man of the match.
So, it's one of these ones where it's shot in, saved by saved by Bloor. It's still loose, and the Stars have equalised, and it's Chris Sykes with the goal. I'm not sure anyone really knew where that was for a while.
We got stuck under Matty's arm, and as he fell back, the puck was dislodged and then flicked back out in front, and waiting on the doorstep was the Stars player just to bang it home. Didn't really need much to force it over the line with a gaping net out in front of him.
One.
Stars probably going to feel vindicated after getting that one with all the pressure they put on.
2-2 then, 10:25 to go. I mean, I said in the second period break to you, I said that this was a game that kind of felt like could go to overtime. We're 10 minutes away from it now, but a lot of hockey still to be played, of course, as the Lions yet again give it away in their own zone, allow the Stars to come in the slot area. Gritans with his back to goal though, shot in again. Bloor doesn't know where it is, and again it's been left loose out in front. Round the back of the net it comes now, and it's Lions just cannot get their lines clear now. It still stays in the zone. It's now underneath Fisher, and again the Stars come away with it. 3-on-2. defensively, the Lions are all over the place at the moment. Now Fisher's going to go for it again, but he's not going to get there quickly enough. And the Lions now just need to try and control it. Ryan Keogh goes round to Robert Oxley, who goes back to Keogh. And that pass up the board's given away again by the Lions, and it's just all at sixes and sevens at the moment as Summerton gives it to Yokoyama. Top line on, trying to get a little bit back going for the Lions. Yokoyama forced too far wide on his backhand, tries to give it back to Summerton, who can't stretch his stick out far enough. And we've got 9.09 to go as the Stars come back the other way again. Here is Helens. Helens short side on Bloor. Bloor's lost it once again. He doesn't know where it is. Stars think they've scored. Bloor squeezes his pads together. Light doesn't go on. Arm stays by the referee's side. Exactly 9 to go and we'll have another stoppage. But what is happening in these last 2 minutes to the Lions, Max?
His defensive breakdowns and kind of, mental breakdowns as well. Just passes not going up the boards hard enough. Passes across not going hard enough. Inviting pressure from the Stars.
It's the Stars that win the face-off again. Go behind the Lions net. All one-way traffic at the moment. Back to Helens. Goes down to Walls. Walls goes to the right corner boards. Is out in front. And sure, if that clean shot got away from Walls. Now Lions with the opportunity to come away. But it isn't controlled. Now it's Berehowski with it. Berehowski with Reese in support. Penalty coming. Lions are going back to the power play. And it's a cross-check with 8.31 to go. And apparently, according to our media team on the other side of the ice, Paul Glossop is not particularly happy right now.
I can hear from this side of the ice. As much as I...
I'm going to miss Glossop shouting for the next like 6 months or so. 8.31 to go.
I think my ears might be pleased for a couple of months.
Yeah, that's true.
Once the ringing stopped anyway.
Yeah. I'll enjoy not being quite so cold as well.
Yes. Well, I don't know, British weather and all.
Well, true. And there are still Manchester rings we've got to go.
Yes.
Right, Lions face off on the left-hand side, and it goes past Yokoyama all the way down the ice, and Bloor comes out with his stick. And that one comes off the stick of Sykes. Here is Fisher. So Lions then are on the power play at the moment. Fisher all the way around. Yokoyama will get there, should get there. And kind of chops it back down looking for Gibbs. Comes out in front. Stars can get it clear all the way around to Bloor, who collects with his paddle and then just gives it away straight away. Oh, high stick is called. High stick is called against Chris Sykes, so that won't count.
Not sure how he missed the whistle and continued with the play and put it past Matty Bloor, but...
I think he just did it out of a bit of frustration.
Maybe so, but a couple of attempts from Matty Bloor to get that pass and quick pass it up. And I think we said off mic as well that couple of them opportunities from Bloor have almost landed him on a Dangit's video from Steve Dangle. Yeah.
I see now Stars are having a... it's Joe Dowdle with that penalty. The Stars aren't happy with that call. I must say, stick didn't look particularly high to me.
I think it was because he was moving his stick down. It was in like a diagonal motion, which made it look like it came from higher.
It was the linesman who was right there that called it. So 1:27 to go on the power play for the Lions. Tied at 2 here at the National Ice Centre. And the face-off won by the Stars. Here's Grittans, who seems to be having the puck an awful lot in the final period. Down the ice it comes as they clear the puck. Here's Fisher. Fisher to Grimshaw. That takes a bad bounce off the Zamboni doors. Another regular occurrence here at the NIC. As Grimshaw gets past a couple, is he going to get down there quickly enough? No, he's not. Grittans is going to get there first. And there's a penalty coming against the Lions. That's all been tied up. And that's the end of the Lions power play. S- 7:19 to go. So we've got 48 seconds of 4-on-4, then a Stars penalty as Tyler Summerton in the penalty box for the Lions. Two two, 7:19 to go. Matty Bloor, it's the third time now he's reset his equipment before play can continue. Face off all tied up, comes to the Stars as Grittans dives in there from the right hand side to collect. So 4-on-4 hockey here, is Grittans allowed to turn towards the high slot? He can't get a shot away, Lions only get it partially clear. 30 seconds remain of 4-on-4. Pass forward is deflected by Spraggan. Can't divert it goalwards though as Berehowski finds Cleaves. Cleaves has got to go on his own, gets over the red line and dumps it in. So there won't be any icing. Brown goes behind his net to collect. Plays it with his paddle and the Stars on the right hand side. Cleaves is going to skate hard to keep that one in the zone. Does do so, fires it on net and Brown makes the comfortable save. 3 seconds to go on the Stars penalty. They're about to go on to the power play for a minute and 12. Round the bend they come though. Nice stick work in from Ben Marples. And Lions, it's their turn to clear the puck down the ice. Only gets to the red line where Hellens collects. Feeds it into Sykes, over to the left and hits the side netting. Here's Yukiyama. Yukiyama, can he get it clear? It doesn't even get out of the zone from the Lions. It's been brought down by the Stars. Cleaves then can't get it clear either. He fans on his clearance and battles for it against Hellens. Then Yukiyama gets it clear, but only up to halfway. But then Race helps it on its way down to the left corner board. Twists and turns and tries to kill some more time off the clock. Inside 6 to go now, still tied at 2. 30 seconds to go on the power play to the Stars. Right hand side is Elder and Bloor makes the glove save and the good catch. 5:43 to go, 2-2. 24 seconds to go on the Stars power play, Max.
Just had a message in from Hannah Cleaves. Fitness. Special mention to Xander Cleaves, who hasn't played since December. Doesn't look like he's missed too much of a beat out there.
Not at all. Well, 5:40 to go in this game. Lions on the penalty kill, but it's come to Yukiyama, who's round the bend. He's been brought down. The referee's arm stays down. Yukiyama gets up and stays with it as the Lions try to kill time, and the music is still on for some reason. Now the music's come off as the Stars turn away from one and the Lions are going to go back to full strength here as Spraggan on the right hand side, diving block there from Owen Davis prevents that shot from coming in. Round the back of the net, the Stars have it now as we've got 5:08 to play in this one. Left point shot in, blocked at source. Lions should be able to get this one clear but they can't as the puck falls to Emerson. Emerson on the right hand side. Centre of the blue line now, trying to put one in towards the slot, able to do so. Lions get a poke check away back into the corner. Around the back of the net as we're inside the final 5 of regulation here. Still tied at 2. That took a block off Gibbs, I think. And then Yukiyama tries to help it on its way. Takes a bad bounce. Lions get it out of the zone. Gibbs gets it up and over the red line. Falls on the puck a bit. Gets tied up in front of the DJ there on the far hand side. Gibbs still with it, plays it down. Lions get a change, 4.5 minutes to go. We're getting into almost what you would call golden goal territory now with 4 minutes to go. As it's given away straight to Moss. Lions really working hard defensively at the moment as that one is deflected wide of Matty Bloor's right hand post. Munro goes in to try and get it. Keogh with it. Keogh battles hard, needs some support, still with the puck, manages to get it away to Dan Martin. Dan Martin on the left hand side helps it up on its way. It's out of the zone at least for the Lions. Keogh then gives it to Fisher. Fisher goes down towards the other end of the ice. Inside 4 to go. Here is Fisher trying to feed it across. Nice diving block from the Stars. Opportunity there for the Lions. 3:40 to go now. Here is Keogh. Keogh nips it off the boards, but Elder collects, keeps it in the zone. He can't control it though. And it comes to Grimshaw. Grimshaw tries to go forward and does go forward, but it comes back away again for the Lions. Here is Cleaves. Cleaves tries to advance it up the ice, it's blocked at source, gets it up the ice second time around. Now here is Martin. Martin, that's taken away from him and bobbles up into the air. 3:15 to go now, still 2-2 at the National Ice Centre. Here's Galloway, Yokoyama supporting him, here's Walls, and Walls plays it to nobody, and Yokoyama can get it up into neutral ice. Sykes with it. Offside call against the Stars. They clear the zone, allows Xander Cleaves plenty of time to play this one up the boards. It's kept in the zone though by Emerson. Back to Cleaves again. Goes round the back of the boards to Marples. Marples off the boards, kept in the zone by Emerson once more. Inside 3 minutes to go. Here is Walls, fired in low on net. It's in the slot. Lions need to get it clear. Bloor needs to get a glove on it, and he can't do either. But it is clear out of the zone, all the way into neutral ice. 2.5 minutes to go in this one, and here is Yokoyama. Lions are 2-on-1. Yokoyama trying to play it across, and Gibbs can't get it in at the back post. 2.5 to go here at the National Ice Centre, still 2-2, and the Stars come the other way. Here is Galloway with a shot, and Bloor doesn't hold it, but it goes wide. Oxley round the boards. It's got too much on it for the Lions to get on to the end of. Stars entering the zone on the right hand side. It's come all the way round for Oxley again. Oxley's going to get there, but it's taken away from him. Owen Davis just fires it against him now, and it falls back to Davis on the left hand side. Game being stretched as Lions try and play it up the ice again. Taken away in neutral zone. Summerton books that one out of the air. High sticking was then waved off. Summerton still with it inside the neutral zone. 1:47 to go, still 2-2. Summerton tries to go cross ice, but it's taken away by the Stars captain Elder in the neutral zone. He goes down, referee's arm stays down, and Davis plays it round the boards. Yokoyama should get to that one first. Inside 90 seconds to go. Lovely play from Yokoyama as they try and find Grimshaw now to the Lions, but it's taken away from them. And here is Sykes, 90 seconds to go. Stars enter the zone again on the right hand side. Lions get it away. Nice stick there from Grimshaw. 1:18 left, 2-2. Here's Spraggan over onto the left hand side. Stars with the opportunity to come over the red line. They do so, but it's not particularly well controlled. And Lions will regain possession. They can't control it though. It goes all the way around to the red line. It is helped on its way. Fisher's going to go chasing it. Final minute of the third period. We are tied at 2. Here come the Stars though. They've got a 3-on-2 if they can play this correctly. Here is Sykes. Sykes and Bloor. It hits his pads, loops up in, and makes the catch at the second attempt. 43.1 to go.
Chris, take a breath. That was crazy play up until now. I think a timeout's been called by the Lions or the Stars, one of the two. Possibly the Stars, with the fact that they've got a face-off.
Stars timeout.
Yeah, they've got a face-off in the zone. Probably going to set something up for the last 43 seconds. As fast-paced as that action was, it was all kind of down one end pretty much, apart from a couple of breakaways up the end of the ice for the Lions.
You wonder if that's how... I mean, it was 27.7 seconds where Lions went ahead,
yes,
at the end of the second, so there's still plenty of time. I mean, we know how long 43.1 seconds is in ice hockey. If you haven't got your man of the match in yet, make sure you do it now, just in case there isn't an overtime. And then we'll get to them as quickly as we can at the full-time buzzer. That is the end of the timeout. What have Matt Bradbury and Paul Glossop said to the Lions? What have the Stars said in their huddle as well? 43.1 to go.
Top line for both sides make their way back out onto the ice to contest the face-off.
And of course, if it does go to overtime, 3-on-3 overtime is
a dice roll, a real dice roll.
Yeah, it really is. But 43 seconds before then, face-off is won by the Stars. Here is Spraggan. Spraggan goes down low. Marples is going to collect that. Nobody in a black jersey goes near it. Summerton doesn't go to collect it though, hasn't read the play. The Stars will have it back again. 30 seconds to go. Goes back to the left point. Shot in is really nicely blocked by Yokoyama. And now here's Fisher. Fisher gives it to Summerton. And now here's Yokoyama. Yokoyama back to Summerton. Oh, that's in front. Good save from Brown. 15 seconds to go. And that was the game on Somerton's stick. 10 to go now. Opportunity perhaps for one move from the Stars. 7 seconds, 6 seconds to go. Tied up against the boards. I sense we're going to get an extra maybe 5 minutes of this, as that's the end of the third period. And we are going to overtime here at the National Ice Centre.
Overtime coming up, 2-2 between the Stars and the Lions. Late opportunity, 2-on-1 break. Yokoyama gets a pass across to Somerton, and you're going to have to think game experience kind of comes into play there. Somerton just fires it against the chest instead of making any sort of move.
In that split second, though, he's young, game on the stick. I mean, it did go straight into the... straight into the logo on Brown's chest, but what an opportunity for the Lions there, and hopefully Somerton doesn't feel too despondent there. I saw he's got his head down a little bit. I think he felt that was maybe the game on his tape there, but we are going to overtime here at the National Ice Centre. We are finishing the regular season off in style.
And extra hockey.
We started the season well, we finished the season well. It was just that bit in the middle that wasn't quite right for us. Right then.
There's no official timed break for this. No. So we're just going to...
It's when everyone's ready, I think.
Yeah.
I think they're supposed to be, and whether they're doing it manually in there. Oh, yeah, they've done it on the stopwatch.
Okay.
I was going to say, they're supposed to be.
I didn't know if the refs were just counting on fingers.
So, 5 minutes. Golden goal. 3-on-3 overtime to finish the season. And it looks as though he's sticking with...
Just the top three forwards at the moment.
The top three forwards. Fisher, Somerton, Yokoyama for the Lions.
I mean, speed and skill is the name of the game in overtime.
I mean, you haven't got much more speed and skill than those top three.
I know. And with the way that they played the last minute or so, or just less than a minute, sorry, in that in regulation...
That's a good point for the Lions against second in the league. Regardless of the situation... 5 minutes, golden goal. Place your bets now. Charlie, we don't have a shot count for the third period yet. It's not been put on the board. Face-off is won by the Lions. Well, really, the Stars. Somerton was almost going to get to that second one. Now here is Moss. Bold strategy from Matt Bradbury here to go with three forwards.
Looks like he's playing man-to-man defence. Everyone's got a guy and they'll follow them around the ice. Not give him any sort of, well, try not to give him as much space as possible.
Here's Moss. Moss with Yokoyama for company. And Yokoyama's taking it away from him. Yokoyama, game on his stick. On the left-hand side, Yokoyama's missed
high.
It.
Goes
on
high on
the right-hand side of Brown's post. He got in too tight. 40 seconds gone in overtime. Stars can come the other way now. Fisher just does enough to disrupt the Stars and we'll have a stoppage. 49 seconds gone in overtime, and that's two opportunities for the Lions now in the final minute.
Yeah, one too many handles and dekes from Yokoyama in this bubbly ice that's had a full period and extra now skated over it. I think a bubbling puck just kind of sent that one up high over the net.
Face off then in the Lions zone, all kind of tied up. Eventually comes under the control of Billingham. 1 minute of overtime gone. Nobody was watching where the puck was. Grimshaw going for it. Out in front the puck. Lions are able to win it away. Here is Gibbs. And we are continuing this overtime period as they go over the red line. Gibbs feeding it out in front for Race, and Brown makes the glove save, tries to feed it out, but referee has already blown the whistle. 3:39 to go in overtime.
Lee606 says Mr. Sitter. I don't know how much of that was a sitter.
I mean, I'll have to look back on the replay. I think he got in very tight.
He did, and had to go high with it and
Yoki
on the backhand.
Yokohama and Fisher still out there. They're probably going to play these entire 5 minutes. Here is Fisher. Fisher goes on to his backhand away from one, coming out in front towards Summerton, and it's another glove by Brown. All the frees, 3:33 to go in overtime. It's a nervous one.
Yeah, it definitely
what's
is.
What's incredible is that the game of the entire season, the game that doesn't matter, has been one of the most exciting.
You can't turn competitiveness off, though.
You can't. No, that's the thing. I mean, it does not matter who gets the extra point here, but my word, is it exciting as Sykes almost gets around Summerton. Summerton does well to recover. Tries to go right across the centre of the slot, comes back to Moss. The Stars try to get it away. Here is Sykes with the shot, well wide. Something's come off somebody over on that left-hand side as Bloor makes the save. Not sure what it is.
Came off of Yokohama. I'm not sure if it's a piece of his stick or if it's a piece of his skate.
Bit of his back of his skate by the look of it.
Apparently.
3:04 to go in overtime. And that's forced Summerton and Yokohama off the ice.
A full line change for the Lions.
3:04 to go in overtime. Face off won by the Stars. Moss does really well to get around the bend out in front. Good save. Actually, it was blocked before it got to Bloor. Here is Moss.
Looks like the referee's put the whistle away, as there was clearly a holding the stick call
again,
potentially.
Blocked before it gets to Bloor. Lions having to do well defensively, and they do. And now they're going on the breakaway again, and this time it's Gibbs. Kieran Gibbs with a chance. Kieran Gibbs puts it wide as well. 2:36 to go. Now the Stars are going to come back the other way. Man over on the right hand side if it can be found, but he can't. And down go a couple of Lions players. Play continues. 2:25 to go. We're halfway through overtime. Out in front, that goes all the way across the crease, and nobody in a black jersey can get on the end of that either. Here's Grimshaw. Three opportunities now on a breakaway the Lions have had, and they've missed all of them. They're 2-on-1 coming back the other way again, though. Trying to get across to Grimshaw, and Race doesn't manage to do so. 2 minutes to go in overtime. Still 2-2 here at the National Ice Centre. If the Lions go on to lose this game, as here is Galloway. Galloway fires it into Bloor's glove. If they go on to lose this game, they've only got to look at their shooting there, because that's three breakaways they've had now, and they've failed each and every one of them.
Yeah, and it comes down to something we mentioned earlier as well with decision-making. In those tight opportunities, what are you going to do? And one wide, one high, one into the chest. As that trickles through on Bloor, and he'll cover up.
1:45 to go in overtime. It's you feel the Lions have had better of overtime. They've just not. That Summerton, Yokohama and Gibbs now have all had opportunities.
They are playing the system very well, of like playing man to man, not really giving them any sort of opportunity through the middle. When they do get the opportunity to break, they are breaking quickly.
Here is Sprague and Summerton harassing him. Down low comes in. That is one thing that the Lions have got, this overtime that suits them, as Stars get behind the back of the net looking for that pass out in front, goes all the way across. Is Lions have got the speed advantage, which in 3-on-3 is giving them a great advantage in the overtime period. It's got away from two, and here's Bloor makes a terrific save. Back out in front again, though, and Bloor gets it with his glove. The Stars are convinced they've scored, but the puck comes away, and the Lions come back the other way. Here's Yokohama. Yokohama goes wide, and the Stars were two Stars players were convinced they'd scored there. Here is Yokohama into the final minute of overtime. Fisher. Not entirely sure what was going on there. Fisher still with it. Round the back of the net. Out to Yokohama. Yokohama, he's going to take the shot. Loose out in front as Brown can't get everything on it. The Stars are able to bring it away. Lions can't get a change. 33 seconds to go in overtime. Here is Sykes. Sykes takes the shot. Bloor doesn't hold it, and the Billingham Stars, with 27 seconds to go in overtime, take the win as Bloor yet again doesn't hold on to the puck. And it's Elder, the captain, who puts the rebound home, and Bloor is absolutely furious with himself. The referee goes to have a discussion with the goal judge behind there. The Stars will feel that they deserve that because of the goal that they were convinced went in earlier on in overtime.
I didn't see it hit any sort of pipework. I thought with Matty Bloor throwing up a pad and a leg and an arm, sorry, he got enough on it to touch it wide. But missed opportunities is going to be the story of the day, I think, from Coach Matt Bradbury.
Yeah, absolutely. The Lions fall by 2-3 in overtime. 27.2 seconds to go in overtime. And the Lions have only got to look at themselves, unfortunately. They had 3 opportunities. Scoreboard's now playing up for me, so it's just going to stay as 2-2 on the scoreboard, but the game's done anyway. Lions are going to feel hard done by there, aren't they, having had 3 opportunities?
Yeah, but it's not like they, they had the opportunity. It's not like they didn't. It's just that they didn't capitalize on them. And they weathered the storm from the Stars throughout the whole game. They skated with them. They matched with them. Like we said, that Stars team is in second place in the league. So plenty of positives to take from it. Not the morale boost we were expecting for the end of this game. Tough way to lose.
You can tell by the expression on the Lions players, particularly Yokoyama there. It was a hard-fought game. I wonder a little bit how much the... Not saying that Billingham took their foot off the gas a bit because it wasn't really that important to them either, but if that maybe closed it up a bit... Not taking anything away from the Lions, but you know what I'm getting at.
Yeah, it's, I don't know, it still felt competitive all the way through. I think the Lions executed better in overtime. I think they executed their game plan better. It just came down to a breakdown in the defensive zone. The one time they didn't actually execute leads to the goal.
Yeah, I mean, they just, it's difficult to get away from an opportunity in the final minute of regulation,
yeah,
and 2 breakaways in overtime.
Yeah.
The one in regulation did, but the 2 in overtime didn't even hit the target.
Yeah.
And it just feels the way in which, you know, the overtime just went against him there. I'm gutted. I thought I was going to get my first live shootout commentary. But,
you were just less than
27.2 seconds away, but... You know, Matty Bloor is very frustrated with himself. He will admit he didn't have a particularly good game, didn't hold on to a great deal. But, you know, it is what it is. Lions get a point and they go into their playoff quarter-final against Solway next weekend. Away on Saturday, home on Sunday. Make sure you keep an eye on our social media channels, because that's where you'll find out time and everything, because I'm not... sure when the when that game is facing off yet. It depends when the ice is available. Michael Elder with the man of the match for the Stars. The beers have been in the changing room since COVID, I'm sure.
Yes.
Yeah, still everybody skates over here.
I don't know, everybody still shakes hands at the end of the game.
Yeah. Tristan Grimshaw with the man of the match for the Nottingham Lions. And that is the end of the regular season here at the National Ice Centre. As the Nottingham Lions and the Stars vacate the ice. Superb game, Max. As we said, you can see how disappointed the Lions are. but you've got to look at where the Lions have been. I mean, we finished on
seven.
Thinking it was. Was it 12 minus the 9, then plus 1 here? Was it 4? No, we're on 6. I'm not entirely sure what we're on now. But what I'm saying is, of the... I know that in October, after playing 11 games, we had 8 points.
Yes.
And now... So we got more in the first, like, 11 games than we have done the rest of the season. And that's just that glimpse there of coming back to what we had at the start of the season.
Yeah, and there's been guys that have moved up from the lower Lions too, and adapted themselves well. So the future does look bright for the Lions moving into the playoffs, and obviously into next season as well. I know, need to think about playoffs before the start of next season, but the future does look bright for these Lions.
A few shifts for Parson Mervan there, 16-year-old who only turned 16 on Tuesday, his first game for Lions Wednesday. Skated well, put in a good few shifts there.
Yeah, when he was asked to do a job, he did it well. I don't think Matt Bradbury can have too many complaints on that side of things. And the amount of times that we've mentioned Summerton already,
yeah,
and Barahowski also presented himself well as per usual. These are all guys that are coming through the system. It just proves the system does work.
The system does work, yes, and. There's going to be more and more opportunity at this level for these players to develop their skills, and particularly with Elite League going to 15, National League going to 3 imports.
Yes.
It's going to be, particularly at this level, this is where the youngsters are going to go, because the opportunities higher up, yes, only by one roster spot, but are becoming less and less.
It's something that I would prefer not to see, but I understand why it's happening, if I'm honest.
Yeah, well, I'm wondering, I mean, Matt Bradbury is having a big conversation on that bench over there. Well, we're still going, because I'm going to try and catch his eye and see if I can get him to come round here with this being the last regular season game. But whether he will or not, he seems to be having too much of an interesting conversation over on the bench with some of the Billingham coaches. But... what I will say, if he doesn't like look this way in the next 30 seconds or so, is thank you so much for joining us. It's, what, 9:45 now, to finish off your Sunday evening with the Lions. So we'll be back next Sunday. That's the 2nd of April. Time to be confirmed. And I will we'll put that out on our social media channels as early as we can next week. Our playoff second leg against the Solway Sharks, because, of course, we can't get ice time on the Sunday. On the Saturday. And thank you very much for joining us. Matt's now having another conversation with people, so we'll wrap up and we'll we'll go and talk to him and put the interview out on our social media channels. So from Max and myself, it's been an interesting final game of the regular season for the Lions, but they fall by 3-2 in overtime. Good night.
Good night.